No, don't do that.
Oh yeah, he's recording now.
All right, here we are, everyone. We just queued into Labyrinth of the Ancients. As you can see, that is, those are all player characters with Miro at the front. Crystal Tower, the Labyrinth of the Ancients.
This is a weird 24 man because normally each group will have one tank, but for this one they decided each group needs two tanks.
Well, what happened was they learned from the experiment of this instance and decided to not have two tanks.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying otherwise, I'm just saying, like, they thought, hey, two tanks per group is a good idea, when really it's like, no.
There may be some wipes in this because people don't like to do the mechanics of fights properly. I'm hoping that we don't go through that, but
the wipes are out.
You won't be able to see the fights in Their Majesty because many of them will just kill very quickly.
Their Majesty.
It's one way of putting it.
Those of you that have played Final Fantasy III should recognize this music, as it is the exact same music that was in the zone when you got here in the third game. You'll even remember the music when you fight the end boss. Alright, here we go!
Look at these Dark Knights with their dark side on already.
We have...
That's what I would do.
It's not necessary yet.
The tanks in Group 3, Group C, don't have any stances on.
Anyway, we have Jillian 3 Anderson, 24 DPS. And we have 24 people in this raid, as you can see. These things here show the 8 people in each group.
But yeah, there's no reason not to have Dark Side on. If you're not in combat, your MP regens faster than it drains.
You're not in combat.
Yeah, we're not in combat.
You're not in combat.
We can use elegant teleporters to get around the dungeon later on, and if we wipe, it makes it a lot faster to get back. We are currently in Alliance A.
Both Dark Knights in Group B have their tank stance on. Okay.
So how this room works is there are a bunch of homunculi there. They're just like elementals. Not really all that dangerous. But as you can see, there's 3 different levels of platforms. I don't know how clearly you can see that, but there are... Oh shit, I just got raw breath. Anyway, as you can see, the room is now filled with purple liquid here. And then it'll raise again a second time, and that's where these green platforms that I'm currently standing on now become useful. It's the same in this room as well. This cross here. You got 2 greater demons and a whole bunch of valors.
Sometimes I just like being lazy and standing around. Great, I can heal people in other groups.
This is like the trash before the boss. The boss is usually the hard part of the fight because people just like to tunnel and attack the boss. By tunnel, I mean they don't do anything mechanics, they just straight up attack the boss. And you'll see what the boss is here soon.
Thank you.
right one selected to dodge that. Some people in our group are dead. Yeah, see you later, guys.
Understand.
How did they die exactly?
They got turned, feared, turned to stone, and then killed with, fire. Hey man, this is Tozen. Hey, Tozen! Yes, this is Crystal Tower. I was hoping you'd be able to, join us today, but, unfortunately Tozen. You could not. That's okay, though. I'm glad you're finally able to reach our stream, too. Anyway, I think someone might get locked out. Anyway, here's the first boss. This is the Bone Dragon. He isn't very tough, per se. He has a few things. You gotta drag him to the far edge, but as you can see, there's raised platforms here as well. But I'm gonna just hang back and not attack him at all. Because he's gonna summon these skeletons here called Platinals, and still he's right on the ball. He picks one up immediately. And you wanna drag them back as far as possible. And then kill them. You're gonna get a lot of people who just tunnel and kill them in the center, and that'll probably cause wipes. Piamet, can you throw a stone skin on me? Because unlike the rest of the group, if they do end up running and exploding, they will, yeah, that's what will happen.
They resist stun, so I couldn't,
They kill the dragon before the, thing there. Yeah, so if they hit, basically, you have to kill them all before you kill the dragon, or they run over to the dragon and blow up, which hurts. But you also can't kill them near each other, because they'll tether to each other, speed up, both of them will speed up and run into the boss and blow up. It's kind of annoying, but it happens. So now we get to do that again, where they're just going to... We're just gonna do it again. Here's some more platinals. Someone is dragging it off. Okay. This one here is being dragged off. Okay.
Well, so much for that.
Yeah, they just kill it as quickly as possible. That one is staying in the center, apparently.
It's gonna be very interesting.
Okay, well, three of them are gonna run off. Okay. Oh, no. Okay, they just ran that one to... Okay, they could link. There's a decent... Okay, that one didn't even die. Okay, that one tethered. Okay, this is gonna hurt. Yeah, I'm dead.
Oh, my Helios went off as I died.
This is a fight where you will die on if people do ignore mechanics, and unfortunately, they ignore mechanics a lot. They could turn the dragon back around, though. Now you actually want to kill the dragon. We should win, though. Got it. So that's the first boss, then. Then you get three treasure chests, one for each group. This one comes with Crimson Shoes for summoners and black mages. Alright, look at this. We're back at the beginning. So instead of going to the left, we're now going to go to the right. And there's now one less of these weird pillar things floating around at the top.
I just living dead during that when those ads were hitting, just in case I went to zero HP.
I swapped over to Fist of the Earth and still died.
Yeah, used Light Speed and cast Aspected Helios and died as it went off.
Oh, no.
So it healed like everyone but me. It was like, well, at least they lived, and then the other healer rezzed me.
Yeah.
And then I rezzed Miro.
Alright, so we're in Group A. This is going to branch off into three different paths now.
Rhett was reading some interesting theories on how, like, AoE heals work in this game as regards to, like, who they target first, because they don't hit everyone at once. So it's, like, weird.
Yeah, I've definitely...
Oh, did I get too close?
Yep. Did you fucking pull? Oh my
Should
god.
Should have
not bad.
I wasn't in, so... I don't know. Also, don't be nice to that guy, because he's the one who's a pugilist, and yeah, we don't know. Okay, now we have hurt people in the crowd.
Okay.
No.
Can't do anything until they actually get on their pad.
They may not have enough people because of me. I don't know.
Looks like everybody's in.
I can at least grab this thing.
Oh! No! Hold on. Two of their people went to B.
Doesn't have a threat level, does it?
People are in range.
So how this works is four people have to be on the pad at the front of the path, and it takes the shield off of the Atmos in the one of the other sections. So we're on Group A, so it'll take out the shield in Group B.
Two people who went to the wrong platform have the same last name.
It's
anyway,
all good.
The Atmos is, it's basically the three groups kind of have to work together in that regard, in that they have to have four people on the pad so that the other group can kill their Atmos.
Who isn't rolling on this loot? It's really annoying me.
Not me.
You shouldn't be surprised about that at all.
I mean, it's like, that's I true. Have it in the middle of my screen.
Alright, so...
Do you think I should grab the golems? But I don't trust anyone to do anything properly. Oh wait, that's this fight. I knew that. Oh, we're Group A, so like... I should probably... Is everybody here? No, we're missing a person.
Somebody hanging out outside. So this is the second boss of the wing. This is Thanatos. He can only be hurt by people that are going to be turned into ghosts. Those of us that were just tethered are about to be turned into ghosts. So, here we go. We're putting everything, we try to put everything we can into it. Usually it takes two rounds depending on DPS.
Someone change my markers. Looks like someone changed the aim marker though.
The other groups have to protect their urns. Their urns are what transform you into ghosts. They get attacked by these ghosts that spawn throughout the fight. Sometimes the boss will actually drag the urn over to it, and the healer's got to heal it to break the chain. Ah, there's one of the ghosts right there. They're called Sandmen. Okay, so now that our ghost form has fallen off, we kill the ghost to protect our urn. Or a magic pot. Which, if you recall from other Final Fantasy games, they're the assholes that are always like, give me a cure, or give me an elixir, or in the case of Final Fantasy V, ask me for 12 of them. So now our pot is turning Group B into ghosts so that they can kill the boss. At the same time, nemesis spawn around the room that we just killed. They're not too difficult, just more of an annoyance than anything else. And there he goes, he's dead. That's not a very difficult fight. Hey, Sabatons of Light.
For the viewer, someone from PMN.
And now we're going across the way here to the third wing. As you can see above here, we only have one of these weird obelisks spinning around the it now. I may get locked out of the final boss because of I'm going to be watching the cutscene.
We'll see what happens.
If I do get locked out, it's not a huge deal. I can just observe the fight and everybody can see it.
But I'll be watching the cutscene too. Just kidding. Well, I could.
And we just jump down here. You could run down, but I don't think anybody ever does that. This is a pretty cool area.
What if you put... Can you video edit, like, from our desk what the cutscene is before the final boss and then participate in the final boss?
I could, but I don't like to do any video editing, so...
One on the back?
No, we're the ones on the left.
Okay.
Okay, so it's A, B, C, like, counterclockwise?
Everyone's inside, so...
Yeah. So, for this mini-boss here, we just gotta kill our Visago here. Now, that is fairly simple task, but at the same time, it also summons bombs. And the bombs gotta be killed.
You told me counterclockwise. I misunderstood. So I put, like, A at the wrong place.
No, I'm here.
No, someone else did that. And then they put C down where I was putting A, and I'm like, no. And I got rid of C, and I was gonna put it down where A is, and then I saw the A, and I was like, what?
Anyway, we gotta kill the Visago, we gotta do that. Eventually they're gonna lay a big AoE on the platform that we don't stand in. It's a nice little fire spot.
I like my Kotei, because he's just been in defiance the entire time. Doesn't matter.
We got an elegant balloon here. Got an elegant napalm here. There's our flame burst. Alright, so the thing is, if you don't kill these Visago very quickly, they channel up their energy into this bomb here in the center, the Allegan bomb. And it blows up and kills the group. If you let too many napalms and too many bombs explode throughout the fight, they power up this bomb in the center, it blows up and wipes the raid. So as you can see, there's lots of raid wiping going on if you screw things up. I like this area. It's really big, really bright, really easy to see what the heck everything is. Lots of magma. You don't want to fall off and die. I don't think you can, but I'm pretty sure if you fell off, you'd die. Unless it's not really magma, it just looks like magma.
Miro, I can help you with the video editing.
I already said I didn't want to do that.
Oh, okay.
It takes too long.
That was... This guy got dibs on Colossus. He's not in C, so I assume he knows what he's doing somewhat.
Seriously,
C is...
C.
They have a pugilist in it! And they're trolls, and two of the other people don't know how to count, so...
Alright, so this is the King Behemoth. The platforms around the room are relevant. He's going to do some fun stuff. People are going to get marked to drop meteors.
Often I hit this thing.
Whenever someone does a ready check after the pull, or like as they pull, I want to hit no.
See this mark above my head? This means I'm going to get a meteor landing on my head. So I'm going to place this away from other meteors, but also away from the Iron Giant, which that person who picked up the Iron Giant has just tanking him right on the boss.
Nice.
It's great, I guess. Anyway.
It's okay.
The towers, they light up, and it just got blown up because they tanked the Iron Giant on the tower. Good job.
Oh, I might die here.
Okay, so he is summoning a meteor, and I may die as well. No, I'm okay, I think. Yes.
I survived too. Yay.
Alright, so what happens is the meteors protect you from his, his comets, I guess is what they're called, actually. They lay those green markers, they lay a rock on the ground. And then the Iron Giant will destroy them because he's an asshole. But you need them because, okay, the behemoth is now over here. Anyway. Oh, it's because Group C's tank died. Alright.
Not a lot of things in Loda. But this is a first.
Alright,
so. Do I need to pull the boss?
You may have to.
I actually thought you were tanking the boss.
Okay, that one just blew up. Alright.
Who else needs to cover my thing then? I'm gonna die.
Alright, nope. So,
is there another boss? Jesus Christ. It's so far away.
Everybody close there may die. No, we're okay. Shoot.
Oh, thank God.
So, yeah, the comets protect you from meteor, as you've seen. You know he's casting meteor because he says, Grah!
What are these winds?
Those are the boss's charbo. Okay, he's already flipped.
Yeah, too. Our DPS is so high, but this encounter is still like. If you fuck up mechanics.
It's not that the DPS is really high, it's more along the lines that the DPS are just ignoring all the mechanics.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, the DPS is so high that you have to deal with the mechanics more often. That's what I mean. But even with high DPS, you're not going to, like, be able to do the fight.
Yeah.
If you don't do the mechanics right.
This opens up the elevator to the upper floors. And up it goes. Where? We get the final chamber. Phlegathon himself. He was a boss in Final Fantasy III's Crystal Tower. Alright, I'm on my way. Unfortunately, load times are not being friendly.
Sprint, Mira, sprint.
I can't sprint yet.
Oh no, you're 15 seconds, you're gonna make it!
I got it, I'm in, I did it.
Nice.
So this is a boss. He's got a lot of really cool mechanics to dodge, but we may not get to see it. Oh, here's Abyssal Slash. So, as the fight goes on, Abyssal Slash gets a lot more dangerous. Okay, where is my... Iron Claws are out. So, when the Iron Claws spawn, you want to run over and stand on this platform. Okay, that was really early.
Yeah, they kind of went too early, but just ran harder.
At least I got on the pads.
Wait, if you go on the pads early, it does stuff?
It opens up the shield. I'm not sure how long the shield lasts.
I was on the pads as soon as it opened, because...
Well, yeah. In most cases, that's alright. But...
Well, Silly did say, literally taken, go to the pads as soon as you possibly can.
Well, I said as soon as the fire disappears.
Yeah, which is as soon as you possibly can without standing in the fire.
Yes, we finally reached the big boss guy of this wing. There's actually still more Crystal Tower, but we won't be doing that today. We'll be doing that in 2 weeks' time.
2 weeks?
I already told you I won't be here next week.
What?
I already told you I won't be here next week.
Is this like your friend's like multiple day wedding?
What?
What?
I don't know.
Okay, first, no, but second, even if it was, I have no idea what you're talking about, but... yes, this boss can call others to help him, which is what he does right here.
Where is it going?
It was like, fuck it, I'm not fighting this group, see ya.
Mira's here? Mira's gonna kill me.
Exactly. I just tried to flee.
Crazy.
He's almost dead though, he doesn't take long to kill. I'm hoping he'll use more of his abilities so you get a general idea of what you actually have to deal with, but so far he's just auto-attacking like an asshole. Moonlight Slash, we'll get to see that at least. Quake 3! I'm glad he used that, because that's a really graphically cool, awesome attack. Use 1,000 cuts! He's not gonna do that. Oh, there's Vacuum Slash. Well, at least you got to see that. And there's our team of adventurers. Piamet's in the very back. Labyrinth of the Ancients complete! Alright, let's give our player accommodation to... I don't know. That person.
I gave it to the healer just because it rezzed me and didn't seem bad.
Aha! I won! Tumbling down!
Nice.
Alright, so now we're gonna leave. As you can see on the other side of that door, there is the Crystal Tower looming ahead. Leave duty. Alright, I may have to share screens here.
Ho there, Miro.
Oh, yeah, ho.
Very impressive, I must say. Your name shall be writ large in the volumes that are sure to be penned on this historic expedition. The scale of this structure defies comprehension. Somebody plainly thought bigger was better. According to the findings of my Baldessian colleagues, the Crystal Tower was constructed to collect and store the endless energies of the sun, a characteristically ambitious undertaking. Now, what of the tower's inner defenses? Judging by your haggard expression, clearing out the labyrinth was no small feat. A giant of a man wielding shimmering scimitar, you say? Yes, that will have been Phlegethon, not Archeron. Phlegethon. He was a hero of the Allegan Revolution. And you gleaned that from what exactly? His choice of weapon? Well, I am a historian, and I have a certain, shall we say, affinity for the lore of the Allegan Empire. It is, of course, all knowledge gleaned from musty scrolls and tomes. The ancient text claims that the Crystal Tower is defended by the champions of Eld, resurrected and augmented through the Allegan's extraordinary technology.
Chief! You need to see this!
Well, well, there it is, the foot of the tower. What surprises do you have in store for us, I wonder? I can't tell you how glad I am to have you with us on this little jaunt, old friend. Had you not beaten a path through that maze, I very much doubt we'd be standing here now. Well, we have much to discuss and digest. Let us retire to St. Konishfind for the present, and then there plan our next step. Lest there be any doubt, our expedition has some way to go yet.
Alright, well, we will turn in the rest of this next week. For now, thank you everybody for joining me for Crystal Tower. Not next week, next stream. We will be back with more Final Fantasy XIV eventually, and you'll be able to see the exciting conclusion of this place as we no longer have to wait for any fates to spawn. That said, have a good one, everyone. We'll see you tomorrow for Final Fantasy XI. Bye-bye.
Bye.